Boise, Idaho, AP, with Idaho Governor Brad Little out of the state on Tuesday, Lieutenant Governor Janice McGeehan issued an executive order involving COVID-19 vaccine. "Oh no, you don't," said Little, who promised to rescind it in quick order. The maneuvering of Idaho's top leaders came while Little was in Texas meeting with 9 other Republican governors over concerns on how President Joe Biden is handling border issues. McGeehan, a far-right Republican, is running for governor. In Idaho, the governor and lieutenant governor don't run on the same ticket. McGeehan's executive order issued Tuesday afternoon seeks, among other things, to prevent employers from requiring their employees be vaccinated against COVID-19. Most mainstream Republicans prefer to stay out of the employee-employer relationship. "I am in Texas performing my duties as the duly elected governor of Idaho, and I have not authorized the lieutenant governor to act on my behalf," Little said in a statement shortly after arriving in Texas on Tuesday. "I will be rescinding and reversing any actions taken by the lieutenant governor when I return." Little was expected to be back in the state Wednesday evening. Also on Tuesday, McGeehan was rebuffed by Major General Michael J. Garshak in a query about activating troops and sending them to the U.S.-Mexico. "As of Wednesday, my constitutional authority as governor affords me the power of activating the Idaho National Guard," McGeehan wrote to Garshak in the letter obtained by the Associated Press. "As the Adjutant General, I am requesting information from you on the steps needed for the governor to activate the National Guard." Garshak replied with one paragraph on Tuesday: "I am unaware of any request for Idaho National Guard assistance under the Emergency Management Assistance Compact, EMAC, from Texas or Arizona," Garshak wrote, in part, to McGeehan. "As you are aware, the Idaho National Guard is not a law enforcement agency." Little in June sent a team of Idaho State Police troopers to the border to help with intelligence gathering and investigative work to stop drugs from coming across the border. Republican Governor Greg Abbott of Texas and Republican Governor Doug Ducey of Arizona had requested the help under the Emergency Management Assistance Compact that empowers states to help other states in times of disasters. On September 24, I spoke to my counterpart in Texas, LT Governor Dan Patrick's office, and they affirmed the need for additional resources in helping the situation on our southern border, McGeehan told Garsh. McGeehan's office on Tuesday didn't respond to a request for comment. "Attempting to deploy our National Guard for political grandstanding is an affront to the Idaho Constitution and insults the men and women who have dedicated their life to serving our state and the country," Little said in a statement. In May, when Little was out of state, she issued an executive order banning mask mandates that Little eliminated when he returned, saying mask mandate decisions were best left to local officials. Little has never issued